Kindly be seated. Good evening, brothers and sisters, and welcome to this holy half-hour adoration as a parish community to thank, adore, and worship Jesus, and to thankfully bid goodbye to the year 2021 and welcome the gift of the new year 2022. Even as we are here, specially to thank God for the year 2021, there is one question which will arise in our minds. Have we experienced anything good in the year 2021? Most of us will probably say, how can we thank God when 2021 has been a terrible year? So many have lost their jobs. Our dear ones have died. So much illnesses, so much misery. Our children's studies were interrupted. Going to church and sacraments was not possible. We were not able to attend funerals. Some of us had to do away with basic needs. And yet the scripture confirms, in everything you thank, for this is the will of God. Did you know who is the greatest saint in the world? It is not the one who prays the most or fasts the most. It is not he who gives most alms, but it is he who is always thankful to God, who wills everything that God wills, surrenders all to God, and has a heart always ready to praise him in all circumstances, good or bad. And therefore, friends, we are here to thank God for the good and not so good things that we experienced in the year 2021. In the silence of our hearts, let us now recall all the pains and tears we shed and surrender to the Lord as we prayerfully sing the hymn, "All to Jesus I Surrender."
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus went on to say, "There was once a man who had two sons. The younger one said to him, 'Father, give me a share of the property now.' So the man divided his property between his two sons. After a few days, the younger son sold his part of the property and left home with the money. He went to a country far away where he wasted his money in reckless living. He spent everything he had. Then a severe famine spread over that country and he was left without a thing. So he went to work for one of the citizens of that country who sent him out to his farm to take care of pigs. He wished he could fill himself with the bean pods the pigs ate, but no one gave him anything to eat. At last he came to his senses and said, 'All my father's hired workers have more than they can to eat, and here I am about to starve. I will get up and go to my father and say, Father, I have sinned against God and against you. I am no longer fit to be called your son. Treat me as one of your hired workers.' So he got up and started back to his father. He was still a long way from home when his father saw him. His heart was filled with pity, and he ran and threw his arms around his son, and he kissed him. 'Father,' the son said, 'I have sinned against God and against you. I am no longer fit to be called your son.' But the father called his servants. 'Hurry,' he said, 'bring the best robes and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and shoes on his feet. Then go and get the prize calf and kill it, and let us celebrate with a feast. For this son of mine was dead, but now he is alive. He was lost, but now he has been found.' And so the feasting began. In the meantime, the elder son was out in the field On his way back, when he came close to the house, he heard the music and the dancing. So he called one of the servants and asked him, "What's going on?" "Your brother has come back," he said. "And your father has killed the prize calf because he got him back safe and sound." The elder brother was so angry that he would not go into the house. So his father came out and begged him to come in. But he answered his father, "Look, all these years I have worked for you like a slave and have never disobeyed your orders. What have you given me? Not even a goat for my friends to have a feast with." But this son of yours wasted all your property on prostitutes, and when he comes back home, you kill the prize calf for him. "My son," the father answered, "you are always here with me, and everything I have is yours. But we had to celebrate and be happy, because your brother was dead, but now he is alive. He was lost, but now he has been found." The Gospel of the Lord.
Reflection. This reading taken for Thanksgiving hour might surprise us, as we normally quote this passage for repentance. We think we already know what the parable is about. Then we close ourselves to its depth. The challenge lies in helping to twist the kaleidoscope to allow us to see the parable's pieces arranged in different ways, so we might experience the power of God's Word even more greatly and cooperate with the Holy Spirit to live it out in our lives. The one value is the Father's thankful heart. Why? Because He accepts the return of his wayward son with gratitude and joy. The key message of the father's gratitude is reflected in his attitude, as we read in verses 22 and 23. "But the father said to his servants, 'Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the fattened calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found.' So they began to celebrate." Is it hard for us to accept the reaction of the father in welcoming the return of his wayward son? Would any of us dare to do what the father did? I am sure none of us would react in this fashion. On the contrary, we would be grumbling, cursing, and ignoring his return and making life difficult for him. Let us be sure that the Father, having forgiven his son today, does not wake up the next day to begin a lifetime of nagging his son, a lifetime of reminding his son of how much he had forgiven him. On the contrary, we are sure that there will be no daily reminders of the ridiculous life his son had led, because the father has moved on emotionally. He has wiped the son's slate clean and has also rid himself of any memory of disappointment that could haunt him for the rest of his life. He counts his blessings and leaves the burden of his son's sins behind him. I am reminded to bring to our attention the lesson we learn from Jesus in the Gospel of John, chapter 21, when Jesus invites Peter to feed and tend his lambs, that is, our children and youth, and his sheep, that is, the adults, married couples, and senior citizens. In spite of the fact that Peter had denied him thrice, a grateful heart is what every disciple of Jesus must possess. Paul teaches us this truth in his letter to the Romans, chapter 8, verse 28. We know that all things work together for good, and those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. It means that no matter how grave the circumstances appear, God will use those circumstances for our good. Further, in his first letter to the Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 16 to 18, Paul brings out the magnitude of this message, where he admonishes us to rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Ever wondered what God's will is? It's this: that we rejoice, that we pray, and that we give thanks, and we do all the things, not only in good times but in bad times as well. Let us reflect as the choir takes the hymn, Shepherd of My Soul.
Let us now express our thanks in spite of the difficult year 2021. For our Pope, Lord, we offer you thanks for our Pope Francis, who dedicated this year to Saint Joseph, through which we learned much of his virtues. also for inviting the whole church to embrace synodal journey of the Synod 2021 to 2023 to have a synodal church. Parish team, Lord, we offer you thanks for the gift of our parish team, Father Brian, Father Joe Albuquerque, Father Gerard, and Father Joe Prabhu, who serve us with much love, dedication, and pastoral care. Through them, we experience your presence in the sacraments. For frontline workers, Lord, we offer you thanks for our doctors, nurses, and other staff who courageously faced the harsh realities of the pandemic and served to look after the patients affected by the virus, risking their own lives. For our families, Lord, we offer our thanks for our families, for their constant support, understanding, and forgiveness. For our parents, we offer our thanks for our parents who love us and let go of their dreams and desires and sacrifice for us so that we can achieve our dreams and desires. For our children and youth, we offer our thanks for our children who are the gift from you. They fill our hearts and homes with joy and laughter. For our senior citizens and homebound, we offer our thanks to you for our senior citizens and homebound who are the channels of your presence in our midst because of their wisdom and love for you. Let us respond to this love as we take the hymn, What Thanks, O Lord, Can I Render Thee?
Sing him a song that is new. Play loudly with all your skill. What thanks, O Lord, can I render thee for all the gifts thou hast showered on me? Each day I sing of thy praise and glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Pray for the new year. Kindly kneel. Thank you, Jesus, for all that you've allowed into our lives this past year, which have reminded us how much we need you and rely on your presence every single day. As we enter the new year 2022, we pray for your Spirit to lead us each step of this new year. We ask that you guide our decisions and turn our hearts to deeply desire you above all else. We implore your blessings upon each of us as we place our lives into your loving hands, for a bright, healthy, peaceful, and spirit-filled new year 2022. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us the memorial of your passion, grant that we may so reverence the sacred mysteries of your body and blood that the taste of the fruit of your redemption may ever be within us who live and reign forever and ever. The divine praises. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be your holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be your glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and his saints. My dear friends, we have come to the end of this holy half hour. We end now with the hymn, "What Thanks, O Lord, We Can Render Thee." And in a few moments from now, we will begin our Eucharist of the New Year.
Sing with all your soul.